How frustrating was it just to lose it in, the, you know, in those dying seconds after you've worked so hard to get a point that you had got one?
Well, yeah, of course. You know, any late goal like that is always a tough one to take. You know, in the end, you know, we would have taken the point. We came here to win tonight. There's no doubt about that. And we're struggling to look, myself, staff, and the players, past the penalty decisions tonight, which were cruel on us, really, the four of them. So yeah, tough one to take. And no disappointment with the players, no frustrations with them. Opposite feelings, if anything. They're obviously very angry and feel more than hard done by. You know, we have to make sure, and we will, that it doesn't affect us going into the next game at Blackburn.
Was the Andre Ayew the one that's probably caused the most fury among the players?
Which one?
The one on Ayew?
Yeah, which one?
The one he got fouled in, he got brought down by Dennis Adore.
The second one, well, the first one was cleared in the first half, and the keeper brought him down. And obviously, clearly, with the second, with the Adore as well, second half, and it's handball. You know, full back, I think it was the left back was in an unnatural left arm was in an unnatural position, and then the one he gives, Connor doesn't even know where he is, you know, and you're like, I've been to see the referee, and we're not going to criticise him too much here. Obviously, we disagree fundamentally with the decisions, especially after seeing them back, but we've just said that we have to report this. Further and beyond the normal reporting system of referees' performances, which we do online in the system, but we have to take it a bit further because that cannot happen.
What does that mean, take for what's to the head of the referees or?
Yeah, we're just looking at now what that looks like. Yeah, but you know we need to help the game. We need to help the game. If we don't share our feelings politely and respectfully, although that's quite difficult to feel at the moment. Then you know we won't be helping the game.
A little consolation tonight, but would VAR help things for you tonight? Do you think? Are you
Listen, we haven't got VAR in the league. I know it's a natural question, and there's been so much talk about VAR in the Premier League and Champions League and et cetera, at the highest level. Listen, if it's a Premier League game tonight, it's a completely different game, isn't it? You know, but it's not. So we are still in the. We are still in the hands of trusting referees to be at the level. Quite and clearly, you know, that's not always the case in this league.
Quite Dimitrovic, obviously, getting the winner at the end. It seemed that Rodman Kabanga really done a great job.
The whole team, you know. Amazed. Yeah, the whole team. And listen, I know there were spells tonight where we didn't have the ball. And, okay, that's not exactly what we want, but we accept that sometimes. The games can go like that. But I think Knockhart had a shot early on, which was a difficult one for Freddie, which he dealt with. And I can't think of another clear chance that they had, apart from the penalty, which Freddie makes a brilliant double save. How we must be feeling tonight is unbelievable, really. They've not, for, you know, to talk about the comments about the defending, you know, they've not really created a chance of any note. So. Or certainly with Freddie having to save. So, and again, you know, when we did take care of the ball, we got into good positions, and their keeper have made a couple of saves. So, listen, it's a tough one at the moment, isn't it? Because of the nature of it, and we've been unfairly treated tonight by the officials, wrong, completely wrong with what we got tonight, and you know, but. I've said to the players all along. You know, if we do anything, we've got to do it on our own and together. We've got to stick together. We're not little old Swansea out of the way. You know, we're strong and we're going to stick together. And whatever we do this year, it won't be for a lack of fight and believing in what we do, even if we're fighting against more than just the teams that we're playing against.
Steve, you spoke about conversations with the referee. Would you want to see change? Obviously, you want the decision to be made right, but how do you think that can happen?
Well, I just think that, you know, I understand that, you know, they can be prone to mistakes, and then these things can happen, but not as clearly as that and so many in one game. I just think there needs to be a realisation of actually what we are receiving on the pitch, and not just us, I think a few teams, but tonight, you know, so it needs to go higher than than the normal, as I said, the normal process of filling in the forms that we have to online and providing feedback. It needs to go higher than that. You know, this is an important league, really important league, and you know, for clubs trying to sustain their status, you know, not as much as anything else. So when you're doing that and things are against you anyway, to be on the receiving end of a performance and decisions like that is not. And I'm not just saying this because we've lost the game last minute and you know there's been some awful decisions have gone against us. You know, we need to make the game better. That can't happen that tonight. It's unacceptable. Well, there's an update on Mike. He's had to have an operation today. So that's unfortunate for him. He had a checkup scan yesterday, and unfortunately the knee hadn't recovered as we thought it would and should. So he's had to go into surgery straight away, which more or less rules him out for the season. He might be back for the last game. He's thinking he will, Mike being Mike. But yeah, he's had a tough one as well. So we've got four young but good centre-backs. Joe and Benny have obviously played really well in the last two games. I've got to say, back to Fulham, you know, 1,500 fans run the stadium, you know, completely dominated the noise. I felt really sorry for them that they've got, you know, 3.5-4 hours back down the M4. You know, I feel sorry for them as well. People paid a lot of money to come here tonight. I really, really respect that and are grateful. And I know the players are as well. So, you know, I really want to show officially my gratitude. And I know I say it quite a lot and all that sort of stuff. But tonight to come here, I know there's only three sides, but to make the noise that they did and completely run the stadium with the atmosphere, you know, for that to happen last minute as well is unfair on them too.